This is the original chair, torture chair. I wouldn't mind getting Drew in it. Still, anyway, my job is to restore and feed and do the leather bits.
There we go.
So I'll have to take all the leather items off it, the headrest, the backrest, and the seat.
With three decades of experience, Martin can read this chair's life story by examining the wear on the leather.
Yeah, we've got the seat here. You can see the colour's dropped out of it. I mean, I'm not being funny, but that's seen some backsides in its time, and I can feel the agony leaping out at me. And I'm surprised it hasn't got clasps on the arms and clasps on the legs to hold you down, ready for the next... I always like this part, purely because it's great. You get... This stuff is magic. This is my magic stuff. Oil, pigment, and a beeswax. You get a tremendous difference from something that's dirty like this. Unloved, unappreciated, and dry. This is a good bit. I like doing this. Watch it. You see the color come back. You know, it's lovely to be able to do this, to remember how it was and see how it transforming. But the beauty of this stuff, it doesn't dye it, it doesn't take away all the patina.
With the leather already more supple, Martin can now turn his attention to the torn areas. To repair them, he'll be using some rather appropriate tools.
You might recognize, well, no, you won't recognize them, but your dentist will recognize them. But they're handy things, just for what I need. It's got to go under, but you've got to get it under without widening it. I need to insert a piece of leather underneath this, and they're ideal. There it is. Now you know why these tools come in handy. Right. This is a good adhesive. It's a cobbler's adhesive. It does the job great, purely because it stays flexible, which is ideal on a seat. You know, when somebody's going to use it, it needs to stay flexible and won't break. We just help it along. And there we go. Now, you've got the scar there, but at least it won't lift and it won't catch. Right, I'll leave that for 12 hours to dry. I've done as much as I can with the leather work. The difficult bit now is to get these 100-year-old hydraulics working.
This chair was one of the most advanced of its era due to its hydraulic mechanism. Pushing down on the lever should cause a piston or ram to rise and lift the seat.
The aim of today is to take the pump off the base and work out why this pump arm isn't working. This lever, pump it and the ram should go up. Maybe something's come apart or something's loose, or it might even be broken on the inside. At the moment, I'm just trying to take it apart carefully so that it doesn't break anything. It's fairly dirty, isn't it? Ah, look, the arm snapped off. The arm, which pushes the pump piston up and down, has sheared off. And you can see that by rotating the arm all the way round, and you can see the stub at the back. I wonder where that's gone.
If the missing piece of engineering isn't somewhere inside the mechanism, the chair won't work again. Bowes decided to go fishing in the sump, a vault-like cavity filled with century-old hydraulic fluid.
Normally I'd wear gloves, but this is far too exciting, so I'm just cracking on with it. I'm finding all sorts in the sump. Some odd-shaped bits of metal, some broken bits of spring. We found some bits of pushrod, good range of different-shaped bits of metal.
There are plenty of fragments of the chair to be found, but so far, no sign of the vital components.
And here it is. They're looking really good. Well, the old one's looking rubbish and the new one's looking fantastic. And fingers crossed, it does the job it's supposed to.
Moving it out of the way. Bring. Yes. Yes, perfect.
The question now is, once the heavyweight hydraulics go back together, will the vintage chair rise again?
Look at that. First pump, I've just leant on the pedal. First pump and the ram's just lifted immediately. Gosh, I wonder how high it'll go. Isn't that the coolest thing? 120 years old, it still works.
A week ago, Drew found this Victorian dentist chair in pieces and non-functional. Its mechanism paralyzed, its leather almost irretrievable. Now it's risen again, with sumptuous leatherwork which retains the character developed over a lifetime, and with its over-engineered hydraulics back to magnificent working order. Leather restorer Martin Ashworth has brought it to Drew's North Wales photographic studio for inspection.
I'm really happy with it. I really hope Drew's going to appreciate what it is. He's going to be happy with it. I'm sure he is, because it's just a beautiful bit of kit, like, you know. If he's happy, then I'm happy. I've done my job.